Here are some true facts about continental drift. Earth's crust is divided into about 20 large pieces called tectonic plates. These plates slip and slide around each other on the mantle at a rate of about 4 centimeters per year, like a swarm of bumper cars. Very slow bumper cars. On lava. About 300 million years ago, these plates came together to form one supercontinent called Pangaea, which is Greek for one Earth, or rock orgy, depending on your translator. 125 million years later, they started to drift away and began to form the continents we know now. We can still see evidence of Pangaea today. Africa and South America make it rather obvious that they were together. You can stop sending those wink emoji. We get it. Many continents also share similar glacial features and fossils. It seems what happens in Pangaea does not always stay in Pangaea. The Wilson cycle describes the period of time from the formation of one supercontinent to the next. It takes about 500 million years to go from Pangaea to Pangaea 2, Electric Boogaloo, and we are currently in the awkward middle zone. Today, tectonic plates have large effects on our lives, in the form of earthquakes. Where the plates meet, they shift towards or rub past each other, building stress that is eventually released in the form of an earthquake. I'm not even going to make a joke here. You probably already made one yourself. Nasty. The reason that these plates continue to move billions of years after Earth's formation is primarily because of geothermal energy. This geothermal energy is a result of residual heat from Earth forming, as well as the radioactive decay of unstable elements inside the mantle. Anyone who has microwaved a hot pocket knows what I'm talking about. Just remember, 500 million years from now, your grave may be some of the only evidence of yet another rock orgy. Because that is how the continental drift do.